Welcome to Hypnosis Today, the nation's first web TV talk show that explores the fascinating world of hypnotherapy. Hello, my name is Lisa Machenberg, and I'll be your host, covering a wide variety of subjects to help you understand the power of the subconscious mind and how hypnosis is being used today to help people achieve success, happiness, and prosperity. It is my pleasure to introduce you to my very special guests. My first guest is Paula Getty-Shearer. She's an honors graduate of HMI College of Hypnotherapy. She is also a hypnotherapist who practices at the Disney Family Cancer Center in Burbank, California. And she has with her her very special guest, Yasmin. And Yasmin, you came in to see Paula for dental anxiety. Please help me welcome my guest. Yasmin, I want to start with you. Tell us a little bit about your dental anxiety.
I've had it ever since I was young. I've always had a problem with dentists sticking things in my mouth, their hands, touching my tongue, whatnot. I have a gag reflex, and it's pretty bad. I avoid dentists like the plague. Mm-hmm. It's not something, even calling the dentist was stressful to me.
So what made you decide to go in and get some intervention for this?
Well, I had avoided the dentist so long that I started getting serious issues with my gums and teeth. I was in a lot of pain.
Yes.
I went to the dentist and he said, you need to go to a specialist. Went to the specialist, he said, I don't even remember the procedure, but it's gonna take about 2.5 hours.
Wow.
2 minutes into it, I started gagging. He said, I can't work with you. But I'll tell you what, this hypnotherapist came into my office and I don't know about hypnotherapy. I don't know anything about it, but you know what? Can't hurt to try. And, you know, I'm very skeptical. I'm a control freak.
Sure.
I was like, yeah, okay. I'm going to go in for this stage act. Okay. I'm going to sing like Madonna. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So I was like, no, I don't think so. He's like, well, give it a shot. You know what? If it doesn't work, I'll put you under and I'll do your dental work for free.
Oh, wow.
There went the practical side of me. Oh, okay, I'll get free dental work because this is never going to work.
That's right. So you can't lose either way.
Right.
Now, Paula, how did you meet this dentist?
Well, I didn't know he said that to you, first of all. but I just went in. I knew another lady who was an assistant of his and had done a lot of work with anxiety and medical issues and treatments and that. And so I had talked to him, left my card.
And he found the card.
Right.
And he called you.
He said, I have this client that he was trying to get a root canal done, and he had a raging infection in her mouth. And every time she came in, she would gag, and they had to stop, and they couldn't do it. And so he asked if I could work with her.
So you took the leap of faith and just called the hypnotherapist from the car.
It was the leap of me being cheap, thinking I could get free dental work. But yeah, I called her right away. I'm like, hey. You know, and I went in.
Go and give it your best shot.
And her office was right above a dental office, which was... Not good, but again,
must have been the universe talking to you.
Yes.
So you went in, and tell me about what kind of an induction you would use with this kind of severe dental anxiety.
Well, it's basically a lot of relaxation, and I had to do some desensitization as well. So first session, even getting her into hypnosis, and then a long, slow, progressive relaxation, relaxing her from the top of the head all the way down to her feet, and taking her to her personal place, so some guided imagery. Big Sur was her calm place. We took her there in her own mind, perfect time of day, everything. And then the thing that really helped her a lot was just the anchor, the breathing technique. So she took her left hand, made a fist, deep breath in. On the exhale, nice, slow and easy, relax the hand, release the breath. And her words were calm, relaxed, confident. And from there, just having her use that every day even, so starting these relaxation techniques in her regular life as well.
All right, so Yasmin, did you do your homework?
I did.
And you said that you used it even before your next dental appointment in your everyday life.
I used it in my everyday life.
You also have 5 beautiful children. Did you use it at home with any of your parenting or anything else that's going on?
Actually, I did. I mean, it's stressful, 5 children in 5 different schools doing 3 or 4 different sports at a time. And, you know, I'd start feeling that little vein pop out in my head. And I'd just repeat my
affirmation
and it works. It really does. So
you had real evidence in a real life situation at your home with all that lovely activity going on all around you, to be able to use it to release the stress and feel not less in control, but more in control. Is that right?
Yes.
Well, what was the next thing you did for the second appointment?
Well, she had this pretty big issue with the dental dam. Just the thought of it could make her gag. So I talked to the dentist again. I said, let me have one of the dental dams. Let me bring it into the office with during the session.
Wait a second. You actually went down to the dental office. You said, give me a dental dam.
Yeah. I wanted and to I have it as real as possible.
And you
I
brought an actual dental dam.
Right.
Not one in the imagination?
Well, that would have been second best if I couldn't get it. But I said, let's make it as real as possible. She had this association that this was just this awful thing. So we wanted to change the association. We gave it a name. It was Donnie the Dental Dam.
Donnie. I liked him.
I let her know that it was gonna be her friend. It would keep her mouth open for her. It would catch anything going into the throat. She could breathe. She could swallow. And I wanted also, when we were going through the imagery, the desensitization, going through the whole process, walking her through, that she could feel it, she could smell it. It was no big deal. She would be off in Big Sur somewhere, relaxing, and just let the dentist do their job.
Now, did you give homework again? Did you go home and practice with the dental dam? With Danny, I should say
Donnie with me,
but Donnie stayed in.
Yeah,
but you had the memory of Donnie, what Donnie looked like, smelled like, felt like.
Right.
Yes, beautiful. And then
the other thing was the suctioning. When she mentioned being a control freak, she had to do the suctioning herself when she was trying to get the
I hope they give you a discount for that, because you were doing part of the work.
And so I was saying, you know what? Let's let them do their job. Let's get you nice and relaxed in the chair. Go off in your imagery, be doing your relaxation, the anchor, and let them take care of things. And that was kind of the idea that we gave to her there with the next few sessions.
So what happened when it was time to actually go in to the appointment?
Well, we had three sessions, and then I went ahead and met her there. She had
at the dental office.
Right. I wanted to make sure we got it done. She'd already been in twice, and the dentist said, this infection is really bad. We got to get it done there. And so I went there. I told them to step outside, put her into hypnosis in the dental chair, nice and relaxed again, progressive relaxation, put her at Big Sur. She's doing her anchor. And then I also had an MP3 player with all my relaxation CDs. So put those in her ears. The dentist came in and did his thing there. And we did stop once and had her stop and focus again and do her anchor again and reminded her, because she wasn't using the anchor if she felt any stress or anything. So stopped once, had her do that, let her relax again, and then they continued.
What was it like having your hypnotherapist there in your dental office with
you? It was actually very, very comforting. I mean, I felt bad she was wasting her time with me, but she not only took care of me, she spoke to the whole everyone in the dentist's office and the dentist, and told them how to approach, how to speak to stressed out patients. And they changed their whole voice, their demeanor, how they treated me. And I hope that goes on, because, you know, there's a lot of people that don't go through hypnotherapy.
So, Paula, what you want all of us to know in the studio audience and at home, you should go to every dental appointment, every medical appointment with every client, every time. Yes?
No. I did that just to make sure on that one, but I wanted to give her the tools and techniques, so from then on out, she was good to go.
I've had four dental appointments
since
then.
And do it on her own, exactly.
Tell me about your first dental appointment without Paula there.
I actually was pretty comfortable. I went in, and the dentist actually had a picture that kind of looked like Big Sur, what I imagined. So I did my relaxation, I had forgotten the iPod with the relaxation tape, so all I had was my head and my techniques she had taught me in the picture, and I just stared at it, and I think I went to sleep almost. I mean, it went very smoothly.
You know, I'll bet that you were just in a very deep state of hypnosis, because you could probably still follow the directions, but you were in such a deep state that you were able to be perfectly relaxed and be at the dentist and be a Big Sur in your mind. That sounds wonderful, and what a good experience. You know, Paula, everybody's going to want to learn more about hypnotherapy for medical or dental phobias. And I know that they can reach you under Paula Getty-Shearer at hmigrads.com. I want to thank you so much for coming in and sharing your experiences with us here on Hypnosis Today. I want to thank Paula, and I want to thank Yasmin. We're going to take a short break, but please stay tuned, because when we come back, we're going to meet another HMI hypnotherapist and her client, and we're going to learn how you can use hypnotherapy to help a client with career transitions. Stay tuned. We have a lot more coming up for you on Hypnosis Today.